Well, this morning we're getting new data about firearm-related crimes in this country. StatsCan is out with a new report showing gun crimes rose in 2022, hitting its highest rate since data was first collected. CTV's Tony Grace is standing by with more for us this morning on this. Tony, what stands out in this report? Let's begin there.
Marcia, good morning. When you look at the number of overall crimes committed with firearms in Canada, it's a relatively small number at just under 3% of crimes that are reported to police. But the rate at which violent crimes involving a firearm are being committed, that's what's going up. 1,400 more since 2021, 14,000 incidents altogether. And again, violent crimes involving a firearm, almost 3%. But, you know, it's the share of what are being called serious crimes being committed with a firearm that are really standing out here, such as homicide, attempted murder, robbery, and aggravated assault. For example, StatsCan says firearm-related homicides are at their highest rate since 1991. They also noted an uptick in homicides, violent crimes, I should say, involving handguns, shotguns, and either fully automatic or sawed-off guns. So kind of a flag being raised here about the rate at which these crimes are increasing right across the country, Marcia.
Breaking it down by provinces, which province saw the highest rate of these crimes, Tony?
It was actually in northern Canada, Marcia, the Northwest Territories. We're looking at this based on the number of these crimes that were committed per 100,000 people in the population. Northwest Territories, 230 per 100,000. Second is Nunavut, and third is Yukon. So northern Canada is actually at the front of these statistics when it comes to the rate at which these crimes are being increased. And Marcia, the report notes that BC, Alberta, and southern Ontario, particularly the Toronto area, were areas of concern. But they also noted that there has been an uptick in rural and northern areas, the territory speaking specifically to that. Now, something else I wanted to mention, Marcia, is that this is the highest rate at which police reported violent crimes were being committed with firearms since this data was first compiled in 2021. So certainly something, Marcia, that lawmakers and community advocates will be keeping an eye on. We have these ongoing discussions about gun control, about funding for police services. This is sure to stoke those conversations, these new numbers out from Stats Canada this morning.
Tony, thanks for bringing them to us.
You're welcome.
Appreciate it.